counting important points for returning officer. Disclaimer: this training material is for use in training of election officials. It should not be referred as guideline of ECI. In case of any variance in this training material, the ECI guidelines, rules, laws shall prevail. In this video, we will discuss important points regarding counting which are to be addressed by the returning officer. What is the role of returning officer regarding counting? The counting of votes is done under the supervision and direction of the returning officer. The counting staff is to be appointed by the returning officer. The place of counting should be decided at least 1 week before the date of poll. If the poll being taken in phases, then the first date of the poll. Send proposal of counting centers to ECI for approval soon after last date for withdrawal of nominations. Mandatory notice to candidates regarding counting. Counting of votes for entire AC to be done at one place. If more than 2 hall are required, then ECI's written prior approval is required. In case 2 halls are approved, allot in advance the polling station to be counted in each hall. Intimate candidate accordingly. The place should have a separate entry and exit. Each counting center to have distinct number and each hall to be distinctly numbered. Infrastructure required at the counting center. The counting center should be spacious enough to accommodate infrastructure and officials and agents. Should have adequate lighting with proper standby arrangements like generator, etc. Adequate fire extinguishing equipment. Should be a permanent structure. If unavoidably temporary, take ECI prior approval. Now we will discuss main legal provisions regarding counting. First, we will look after Representation of People Act 1951. Section 64 is about counting of votes. It says, counting under supervision and direction of the returning officer. Contesting candidate, election agent, counting agents have a right to be present. Section 64A, it is about destruction, loss, etc. of ballot papers at the time of counting. It says, returning officer shall immediately report the matter to ECI, who may direct the counting to be stopped. ECI may further declare poll to be void, order repoll for that polling station. Or if satisfied, the result of election will not get materially affected, may allow counting to be completed. Section 65 is about equality of votes. If two or more candidates have equal number of votes, then result will be decided by the draw of lot by returning officer. Section 66 about declaration of results. In the absence of any direction to the contrary from ECI, returning officer to declare the result on completion of counting. Section 67, it is about report of the result. Returning officer to report result to ECI and to appropriate authority, that is secretary, state legislature or parliament, who shall get it published in official gazette immediately. Section 129, it is about officers, etc. at elections not to act for candidates or to influence voting. It is applicable to DO, RO, AROs, polling staff. If violation occurs, then imprisonment up to 6 months or fine or both. Section 136, it is about other offences and penalties thereof. If a government official is guilty of electoral offence or any person is guilty of electoral offence like tampering with EVM, ballot box or ballot paper, nomination paper etc. fraudulently. If violation occurs, then imprisonment up to 6 months for any other person and imprisonment up to 2 years for government officials or fine or both. Now we will see Conduct of Election Rule 1961. Rule 51 is about time and place of counting. To be fixed by returning officer at least 1 week before the date of poll. Notice to be given in writing to each candidate or his election agent. Rule 52, it is about appointment of counting agents. Subject to ECI directions, a candidate may appoint counting agents which shall not exceed 16 for each place of counting. Rule 53, admission to the place of counting. Nobody else except returning officer or ARO, counting staff, candidates, their election agents and counting agents, public servants on duty, persons authorized by ECI can enter in the place of counting. Whosoever misconduct himself or fails to obey lawful direction of returning officer shall be removed from the counting hall. Rule 54. Secrecy of voting. Returning officer to read out provision of section 128 allowed before commencement of counting. Rule 55C. It is about scrutiny and inspection of EVM before counting. Rule 56C is about actual counting. Rule 56D is about scrutiny of paper trail. Rule 57C is about sealing of voting machine. Rule 60 is about provision for continuous counting. Rule 61 is about provision for recommencement of counting after fresh poll. Rule 64, provision for recount of votes. Rule 64, provision for declaration of result of election. Rule 65, provision for counting at two or more places for one constituency. Rule 66, provision for grant of certificate of election to returned candidate. Mobile phone and computer. Mobile telephones, iPad, laptop, or any such electronic device which can record audio or video are not to be allowed inside the counting center. The only exception will be commission's observer. However, computer, laptop or mobile device which is required for official use to transmit counting data by Genesis and mobile phone linked to ETPBS system which receive OTP will be allowed. Randomization of counting staff. First, by district election officer to segregate 120% counting officials 7 days prior to counting. Second, by DO and observer for AC-wise segregation 24 hours prior to counting. In case where necessary, second randomization can be done up to 48 hours prior to counting with approval of CO. Third, by returning officer and observer for counting table allocation at 5 a.m. on the date of counting. The ideal counting center is displayed on the screen. There are 14 tables, 7 on one side and 7 on opposite side. Across each table, there will be sitting arrangement for micro observer, counting supervisor and counting assistant. Sitting arrangement for returning officer, ARO, observer will also be there. And also, table for tabulation work will be there. The first counting table will be earmarked as VCB. Sitting arrangement and counting table is displayed on the screen. There will be a table on which control unit will be placed. Micro observer, counting assistant and counting supervisor will be on one side and counting agents will be on the another side. Persons allowed in counting hall. Counting supervisors, counting assistants and micro observer. Persons authorized by Election Commission of India. Public servants on duty in connection with election. Candidates, their election agents and counting agents. Everybody inside the counting hall shall have to display his I card on his or her person. Priority in sitting. Number 1. Agents of candidates of recognized national parties. Number 2. Agents of candidates of recognized state parties. Number 3. Agents of candidates of recognized state parties of other states permitted to use reserve symbol. then agents of candidate of registered unrecognized parties, and at last, agents of independent candidates, persons who cannot be appointed as counting agents, any person having security cover provided by the government, any sitting minister of union government or state government, sitting member of parliament or member of legislative assembly or legislative council, chief, head, chairperson of urban local bodies, that is a mayor of corporation, chairperson of municipality, nagar panchayat, chairperson of district level zila parishad, block level panchayat samiti, elected chairpersons of national or state or district cooperative institutions, political functionaries appointed as chairpersons of central PSUs or state PSUs, chairperson of government bodies, government leader, additional government leader, any government servant. No person having security cover will become eligible for being appointed as election agent or counting agent, even if he or she surrenders his or her security cover to act as such agent of a candidate during an election. Form 18, that is application for appointment of counting agents, is displayed on the screen. Declaration of counting agents is displayed on the screen. Items to be carried by counting agents. Counting agents are allowed to carry pen, paper, duplicate copy of Form 17C. Before counting starts, everyone present in the counting hall shall take oath as per Rule 128 of RP Act 1951, and this oath is about maintenance of secrecy of voting. Now we will see postal ballot counting. On the counting day, the postal ballot counting will be taken off first, and after a gap of 30 minutes, the EVM counting can also start. The commencement of counting in the EVM in respect of other assembly segments of PC need not wait if they are held in different counting place. There shall be a maximum of 4 tables, and in each round a maximum of 500 ballot papers shall be distributed. If required, the returning officer can make arrangement for a separate hall adjacent to the EVM counting hall where RO is supervising the EVM counting. The format of Form 13C is displayed on the screen. This is also known as large envelope. When we open the large envelope, Form 13C, we will get two things. Form 13A, that is electors declaration, and Form 13B, small envelope. But we have to note that if either of the two materials is not found, then put that material back in the large envelope 13C and write rejected on large envelope 13C, citing the reason for rejection. The format of Form 13A is displayed on the screen. The name of constituency, serial number of ballot paper, signature of elector, address of elector, date will be there. Also, signature of attesting officer, designation and address of attesting officer will be there. Attesting officer can put his official seal or simply write designation or address by pen. Format of small envelope, that is Form 13B, is displayed on the screen. Here, the serial number of ballot paper will be written and also the name of constituency. Now we will see how votes are marked on the ballot paper. Votes can be marked by pen and no specific symbol is defined for making any mark. But any mark should not disclose the identity of the elector. The elector has given his vote to candidate Alpha by putting tick mark. On other ballot paper, the candidate has put his preference by marking X in front of the candidate Gamma. Hence, both the votes are valid. In the first ballot paper, candidate has put two tick marks in front of alpha, and in another ballot paper, the candidate has put circle in front of lambda. Hence, both the votes are valid. On first ballot paper, the elector has given his vote by putting tick mark. This tick mark is in the rectangular box of candidate alpha. Hence, it is a valid vote. On other ballot paper, the elector has given his vote by putting parabola sign for lambda candidate. The sign is in the rectangular box of candidate lambda. Hence, it is also a valid vote. On the ballot paper, which is on the left side, the elector has put the tick mark. While making the tick mark, some little portion, say 10 to 15% of the tick mark, is in the box of candidate beta. But the intention of the elector is to give vote to candidate alpha. The larger portion is in the rectangular box of alpha. Hence, the vote will be counted for the candidate alpha. Similarly, in another ballot paper, the vote will be counted for the candidate lambda. On the ballot paper, which is on the left hand side, the elector has put two symbols, one for lambda and another one for eta. Hence, this ballot paper will be rejected. Similarly, on the ballot paper which is on the right hand side, the elector hasn't given any tick mark or any symbol. Hence, this ballot paper will also be rejected. The ballot paper shown on the screen is spurious. Hence, this will be rejected. On the ballot paper which is on left hand side, the elector has put cross mark. But this cross mark is in between the boxes for candidate beta and candidate gamma. We cannot decide whether the elector has given his vote to beta or gamma. Hence, this will be rejected. Similarly, on another ballot paper which is on the right hand side, the elector has given the tick mark to the candidate beta. But at the same time, the elector has put his signature. So, this ballot paper will be rejected. On the ballot paper which is on the left hand side, the elector has put tick mark. This tick mark is very large. It crosses the rectangular box of alpha, beta and gamma. We cannot decide to which candidate the elector has given his vote. Hence, it will be rejected. Similarly, on the ballot paper which is on the right hand side, the elector hasn't put any mark, but he has written the symbol, the alphabets, YPS. Hence, it will be rejected. We have to avoid the following points while rejecting the postal ballot paper. The postal ballot shall not be rejected merely on the ground that the attesting officer has not put his or her seal on the Declaration 13A. If attesting officer has given full relevant details regarding his or her name, designation, office name, then it shall be accepted. If the sender has not put his signature on the outer cover, Form 13C, and if the identity of the sender is verifiable on the basis of his or her declaration, that is Form 13A, then it shall be accepted. In case the victory margin is less than the total number of rejected postal ballot received, then there should be mandatory re-verification of all rejected postal ballots by the returning officer. Format for recording postal ballot paper is shown on the screen. Format for recording the tally of postal ballot issued to service personnel and received back is shown on the screen. Format for recording postal ballot which is to be done by the micro observer is shown on the screen. Mandatory re-verification of postal ballot. Where the margin of victory is less than the number of postal ballot rejected as invalid at the time of counting, all the rejected postal ballot paper shall be mandatorily re-verified by returning officer before declaration of result. Now we will understand what is the procedure of counting of electronically transmitted postal ballot. There shall be a suitable sitting arrangement for one polling agent of each candidate. Separate ARO to be appointed for each postal ballot ETPB table, and he should be well trained. Counting supervisors and counting agents should be well trained. Never change the mobile number and email till the elections are over. Ensure DND is not activated on the mobile of returning officer. Keep two separate trays, one for ETPBs which are to be counted and one for ETPB which are not to be counted. Hardware required are one desktop or laptop with Windows 7 or above, one QR code scanner. License antivirus should be installed. System should be cleaned with no other data. One UPS for each system and proper power backup. Wired internet connectivity. The QR code scanning sequence will be like this. Step 1. Form 13C will be scanned. Then Form 13A will be scanned. And at last Form 13B will be scanned. Sequence of QR coding scanning should not be changed under any circumstances. Note that QR code of the postal ballot paper is not required to be scanned during the counting of ETPBS. QR code scanning will be for the code on Form 13C label, on Declaration 13A, and on the inner envelope Form 13B. The commanding officer have to download and print the Form 13C. The format is shown on the screen. The commanding officer will also download and print the declaration, that is Form 13A. The format is shown on the screen. The commanding officer will then download and print the Form 13B. The format is shown on the screen. And at last, the commanding officer will download and print the electronic postal ballot. The format as an example is shown on the screen. Again, the format is shown on the screen. Now we will understand counting by control unit. CCTV coverage. CCTV coverage of movement of EVM VVPAT from the strong room to counting hall and display in counting hall is must. Both CCTV coverage and videography shall be done for entire counting process. EVM to be distributed sequentially, that is EVM of polling station number 1 at table number 1 and so on. Nodal officer to ensure that all the EVM are sequentially distributed. Only control unit required for counting. BU to be brought into the hall only if inspection is required. If the green paper seal is not intact, it should immediately be brought to the notice of the returning officer, and in no case, the counting of votes of the particular CU shall be taken or counted without proper approval of the commission. In case returning officer is satisfied that the counting machine has been tampered with or is not the same which was supplied for use at the polling station, the machine should be kept apart and the votes recorded therein should not be counted. Returning officer should report the matter to the ECI. Under the law, it is not necessary to adjourn the entire counting if any voting machine has been found to have been tampered with. Returning officer should, therefore, proceed with the counting in respect of the other polling stations. The sealed control unit, which will be brought on the counting table, is displayed on the screen. After the inspection of the green paper seal and ABCD seal, counting assistant will open the door, which is on the upper back side of the control unit, then switch on the button. Now, the green paper seal will be cut. After then, address tag will be cut. And then the door of the result section of the control unit will be opened. Now press the result button, which is shown by the arrow. After pressing the result button, control unit will start displaying the votes received by different candidates. The sample is shown on the screen. Counting supervisor will note the votes received by different candidates in part 2 of form 17C. The part 2 of form 17C will be prepared in duplicate using carbon copy. The carbon copies will be used to make multiple copies to be made available to counting agents. Original copy will go to returning officers table for round wise tabulation work. The format for round wise tabulation sheet is shown on the screen. In case any control unit does not display result, it should be kept back inside its carrying case and then be kept in returning officer's custody in the counting hall. Counting of votes in other machine should continue as usual. When counting of votes in other machine is complete, the returning officer and observer should take up these control units and their respective VVPATs. After completion of counting of votes, all the control units, the printed paper slips of these respective VVPATs shall be counted as per the counting procedure prescribed by the Commission to count VVPAT paper slips under the Rule 56D. In such a case, also the returning officer and observer should send a detailed report to the Commission in the prescribed format. If there is any malfunctioning of control unit during counting, then the counting of respective VVPAT slips will be done and the report format is shown on the screen. Pro forma for recording of votes by additional counting staff, which is the random checking of 2 EVM after each round, is shown on the screen. Before taking signature of candidates or their agents or counting agents in part 2 of form 17C, in the space between counting supervisor signature and signature of candidate or their agents, write in pen, "We hereby certify that control unit number is the same which were used in the polling station number ... After completion of counting, all the control units, whether the result has been retrieved from it or not, should be kept inside their respective carrying cases. The carrying cases should then be sealed once again. The returning officer and observer should put their signatures on the seal. The candidates and their election agents should also be allowed to put their signature on the seal. The control unit should be then kept in the strong room for resealing. In case any control unit does not display result due to not pressing of close button, it should be kept inside its carrying case and then be kept in the returning officer's custody in the counting hall. Counting of votes in other machine should continue as usual. When counting of votes in other machine is completed, the returning officer and observer should see whether the margin of votes between the first candidate and the runner-up is more or less than the votes polled in such machine. In both the cases where the margin of votes is more or less than the total votes polled in that machine, the returning officer or counting supervisor shall press the total button of the control unit to see the total votes polled in that machine. In case total votes polled in that machine tallies with the total votes polled mentioned in the form 17C, the returning officer or counting supervisor shall press the close button and then the result button for getting result data. Proceeding will be recorded and signatures of the candidate or their counting agents will be taken. In such a case, the returning officer and observer should send a detailed report to the Commission in the prescribed format A. Format A is shown on the screen. In case total votes polled in that machine does not tally with the total votes polled mentioned in the form 17C, the matter should be referred by the returning officer to the Commission for a decision, and action may be taken as per the direction of the Commission. The returning officer and observer should also send a detailed report to the ECI in the prescribed format B, where the margin of vote between the candidates having highest vote and the runner-up is more than the votes pulled in the control unit in question. And in Annexure C, where such margin is less. The format of Annexure B is shown on the screen. The format of Annexure C is shown on the screen. Format of report regarding result not obtained from control unit in counting of BVP paper slips, which is to be sent to the Commission through CO office, is shown on the screen. Round wise result sheet. Only after all EVM of a particular round are counted and parallel counting of two randomly selected EVM by the observer is done and round wise tabulation is completed, only then round wise result sheet shall be given to the candidates to be signed by the RO and observer. Next round of counting will start only when the result of that round has been posted in the blackboard or whiteboard and after announcement in public address system. What happens in case CRC not done or mock poll slips not taken out? If CRC has not been done by the presiding officer, VVPAT paper slips of concerned polling station shall be counted as per the ECI instructions regarding VVPAT slips counting. Even in cases where VVPAT paper slips pertaining to mock poll have not been taken out from the drop box of the VVPAT, the VVPAT slips shall be counted and the candidate-wise votes from the mock poll certificate shall be deducted to arrive at correct count of candidate-wise votes polled. The VVPAT slip count result of all these polling stations shall be added to the candidate-wise tally and then the final result will be compiled. In case of any mismatch between EVM counting and VVPAT slips counting, recounting of VVPAT slips will be done. Even after recounting of particular VVPAT slips, count still do not tally, the VVPAT slip count will prevail as per the Rule 56D of the Conduct of Election Rule 1961 and result sheet shall be amended and final result announced accordingly. Format of report regarding mock poll data not erased from the control unit and the VVPAT slip count is shown on the screen. Replacement of battery in control unit. If the control unit does not display result due to low battery, the battery can be replaced with the new one. Penultimate round. Only counting of votes in EVMs of the counting place where postal ballot counting is going on shall be deferred. Now we will see counting of VVPAT ballot slips. VVPAT counting mock drill. Ensure mock drill of counting of VVPAT slips. For mock drill of VVPAT slips counting, a dummy VVPAT counting booth shall be made. For mock drill, at least 500 VVPAT slips shall be generated. Mock drill of VVPAT slips counting shall be conducted in the presence of the observer. VVPAT counting booth. The counting table close to the RO's table should be made as VCB as far as possible. Only one VCB allowed per assembly constituency. Should have minimum length of 6 feet, breadth 6 feet and height 8 feet and covered by narrow wire mesh. CCTV should be installed on the ceiling just above the counting table for monitoring and recording purposes. For mandatory verification of VVPAT paper slips, 5 polling stations of each assembly constituency will be randomly selected and VVPAT paper slips will be counted and matched with the result displayed by the control unit. The polling stations whose paper slips have been already been counted due to non-display of result from control unit or whatsoever be the reason will not be included for randomization for that purpose. If more than one VVPAT is used in a polling station, then counting should be done separately for each VVPAT. A written intimation regarding the conduction of draw of lots for the random selection of 5 polling stations for verification of VVPAT slips shall be given by the returning officer to the candidates or their election agents well in advance. Procedure for draw of lots. White color paper cards of postcard size shall be used for conducting the draw of lots. Total number of postcards shall be equal to the number of polling stations in assembly constituency. Sample plastic container and sample pigeon hole is shown on the screen. The symbol should be printed in black and white on a plain paper of minimum size 4 inch by 3 inch. At least 100 rubber bands for making bundles of 25 VP paper slips will be required. The part 2 of form 17C, which is to be used for VP paper slip counting, is shown on the screen. Declaration of result. When the counting is completed and the final result sheet in form 20 has been prepared, returning officer should announce the total number of votes polled by each candidate as entered in the form 20. Returning officer should then pause for a minute or two. If during this period any candidate or in his absence his election agent or any of the counting agents ask for a recount, returning officer should ascertain from him regarding the time required by him for applying for recount in writing. Option to make request for recount of polled ballot papers and or polled EVM of all or some of the polling stations. After deciding the recount application, result will be declared after obtaining necessary authorization from observer or necessary approval from ECI wherever needed. Declare the result by loud announcement. Sample of observer's authorization for result declaration is shown on the screen. The final result sheet, Form 20, is shown on the screen. The Part 2 is shown on the screen. If in any constituency the election is uncontested, then the formal declaration of result will be done as per Form 21 for general election, Form 21A for by-election, Form 21B for casual vacancy. The sample of Form 21 is shown on the screen. The sample of Form 21A is shown on the screen. The sample of Form 21C is shown on the screen. Formal declaration of result, either Form 21C or Form 21D. Form 21C is for general election. Form 21D is for by-election. Name and address of elected candidate to be prepared as per the list of contested candidates, that is Form 7A. The format of Form 21C is shown on the screen. The format of Form 21D is shown on the screen. Date of declaration is the date on which result is declared and not the date of dispatch of declaration to appropriate authorities. Complete and certify the return of election in Form 21E. Forward signed copies of Form 21E to ECI and CO of the state concerned. Copy of the Form 21E can be supplied to candidate or agent on payment of Rs. 2. Send copies of signed Form 21C to Election Commission of India, CO of the concerned state. In case of Lok Sabha election, Union Ministry of Law and Justice and Secretary General of Lok Sabha. In case of assembly election, to the state government and secretary to the state legislative assembly. The sample of Form 21E is shown on the screen. Report result of election to ECI by the fax or email without any failure. Chief Electoral Officer of the State, Secretary of State Legislative Assembly or the Secretary General of Lok Sabha, Director of News Services All India Radio, AIR स्टेशन ऑफ स्टेट हेडक्वार्टर, डायरेक्टर दूरदर्शन केंद्र न्यू दिल्ली एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. ग्रांट ऑफ सर्टिफिकेट. एज सून एज कैंडिडेट इज डिक्लेयर्ड इलेक्टेड, ग्रांट सर्टिफिकेट इन फॉर्म 22. द सर्टिफिकेट टू बी इश्यूड इन इंग्लिश और हिंदी और इन ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज ऑफ द स्टेट. ओनली कैंडिडेट और इन हिज एब्सेंस टू अ पर्सन ड्यूली ऑथराइज बाय द कैंडिडेट एंड हु इज पर्सनली नोन टू द रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर कैन रिसीव द सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ इलेक्शन फ्रॉम रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर. ओनली 4 पर्सन्स कैन बी प्रेजेंट एक्सक्लूडिंग द कैंडिडेट और ड्यूली ऑथराइज पर्सन बाय द कैंडिडेट फॉर रिसीविंग द सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ इलेक्शन फ्रॉम रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर. Opt-in from candidate acknowledgement of it is received duly signed. Signature has to be attested by the returning officer only before dispatch to the secretary of the state legislative assembly or the secretary general of the parliament. Send this acknowledgement by registered post with AD. The format of certificate of election, that is form 22, is shown on the screen. Acknowledgement form is shown on the screen. Election papers to be sealed. Packet of register of form 17A including voter slip. Packet of unused postal ballot papers with counter foils attached thereto. Packets of used postal ballot papers valid or rejected including the packets in which covers containing polling stations received late are kept. Packets of used and unused tendered ballot papers. The packets of unused ballot papers meant for display in ballot unit and for use as tendered ballot papers. Packets of counterfoils of used postal ballots. Packets of marked copies of electoral roll. Packets of declaration by electors and attestation of their signs. Mock poll certificate. Safe custody of election records. Appoint a senior officer to supervise sealing of packets. These papers to be sealed with the secret seal of ECI. All to be put in steel trunk. Each steel trunk locked with 2 locks and each lock be sealed. EVM and election paper thus sealed shall be deposited in the safe custody of the DO without delay. DO should ensure that these are deposited in treasury under double lock system. Key of one will be kept with the DO himself and the other key with treasury officer. The envelope sealed under the rule 93 shall not be opened and their contents inspected by any person or authority except under the order of a competent court. Secret seal not to be put on the locks. After sealing of EVMs and election papers, Returning officer should draw proceedings of counting process mentioning full particulars of candidates or their agents present in the counting hall. Facts that they were asked to affix seals on voting machines and packets of election papers if they wished. Particulars of person who had affixed such seal and those persons who refused to do so. Sign the proceedings and obtain signs of the candidates or their agents as present and willing to sign. The proceeding should be kept in a sealed cover along with the other election papers. Return of secret seal. After all packets are sealed, secret seal should be put in a separate packet. The secret seal should be returned immediately after such sealing to the ECI. It should be sent through registered insured post. To be returned to the commission within 24 hours after counting is completed. Dispatch of different forms. Form 21C in Hindi or local language, 4 copies, at the night of declaration of result. Also in English, 4 copies, at the night of declaration of result. Form 21E in English and local language, 4 copies, at the night of declaration of result. Form 20 consolidated and round wise, 2 copies, at the night of declaration of result. Receipt of election certificate, 2 copies, at the night of declaration of result. Index card in 2 copies. RO report in two copies, rejected ballot paper in two copies, handling media during counting. Access to the media into the counting center is governed by the provision of Rule 53 of the Conduct of Election Rules 1961. Only those media persons who have the valid authority letter issued by the ECI can enter into the counting center. Will be allowed to sit in a separate room known as the media room and not in the actual counting hall itself. This room will be near the counting hall. However, they will be allowed inside the counting hall in very small numbers and in batches in regular intervals. A line or string shall be drawn up by the returning officer, beyond which they should not proceed. Officials who escort the media person will remain with the media person throughout their stay in the counting hall and will escort them out after their coverage to the media room. No static camera, still or video of the media is allowed inside any counting hall. Media rooms in the counting center should have the required infrastructural facilities like internet, telephone with ISD-STD connection, fax machine, necessary furniture, and other basic facilities like drinking water, etc. Return of deposit. Condition for return of deposit will be: candidate is not shown in the list of contesting candidates. He dies before commencement of poll. He is elected even if polled less than the 1/6 of total valid votes. He is not elected but gets more than 1/6 of total number of valid votes. No return if polled exactly 1/6 of the total valid votes. If he is contested for more than one constituency, can receive, if valid, only one return. Return of deposit to be made, if valid, as soon as practically possible, soon after publication of list of contesting candidates in case of the invalid nomination, soon after death of candidate in case of death before start of poll. Return second and subsequent deposits, if any, made by candidate along with the nomination papers after publishing Form 7A. In other cases, soon after declaration of result. Votes polled by nota not to be taken into account for calculating the 1/6 polled votes for return of security deposit. Format of application for refund of deposit is shown in next slide. The format of application for refund of deposit made by a candidate is shown on the screen. The format of application for refund of deposit made by a depositor when he is not a candidate is shown on the screen. The format of application for refund of deposit made by the legal representative of the candidate is shown on the screen. In this video, we have seen what are the important points to be covered by the RO during counting. If you have any doubt or want any clarification, then you can contact through the mail as shown on the screen. For other videos on rules and regulation and election related material, you can visit the web address as shown on the screen. Thank you.